Hello everyone, today I'm going to read a wonderful book for you all, and the name of the book is The Man on the Seat of Justice. And the amazing thing is it is written by the author Munshi Premchand and illustrated by Swati Sambasivam, translator Dr. Ramneet Kaur, publisher Story Weaver, a level 4 story. Now let's read about the author. Born on the 31st of July in 1880 as Dhanpat Rai Srivastav, Premchand went on to become one of the most prolific writers in the Indian subcontinent. He was bestowed with the honorary title of Munshi due to his mastery over words. He is considered to be the pioneer of the modernist Hindustani literature. He authored roughly 300 short stories and several dozen novels in his lifetime. Premchand was also a popular dramatist and translator. His famous works include novels like Karma Bhumi, Seva Sadan, Godan, Nirmala, and short stories like Eidgah, Lottery, Bade Bhai Saab, Do Bailon Ki Katha, and Poos Ki Raat, amongst many other notable titles. He was given the title of Upanyas Samrat, Emperor among novelists, by the other writers of his times. Majority of his writings present a slice of life of the pre-independence era. His writing is steeped in realism and he is known for his Hindu-Urdu literature. His style of writing is more direct and he is considered to be the first Hindi writer to showcase the concept of realism in his writings. Subjects like colonialism, corruption, poverty, child widowhood, and exploitation of the poor, etc., feature prominently in his works. He wrote extensively about the life of common people of his times. Munshi Premchand died on October 8, 1936, but his work continues to be commemorated even today. About the story, Algu Chaudhary and Jumman Sheikh were good friends. Jumman's Khala appealed to the Panchayat against him because, despite having taken her property, he did not take proper care of her. Jumman's Khala chose Algu Chaudhary as her panch. Algu Chaudhary chose to be on the side of justice rather than his friendship with Jumman. This soured their relationship. Once again, the Panchayat sat to dispense justice. This time Algu Chaudhary was the accused and Jumman Sheikh was the panch. Jumman Sheikh had wanted to take revenge on Algu Chaudhary only when he sat as a panch. He was unable to side with injustice. This story is about honesty and justice and man's capacity to rise above petty issues and follow his soul. Now let's move ahead in this interesting story. Algu Chaudhary and Jumman Sheikh were good friends. They shared their farm work. They also shared their money. Unshakable mutual trust was the basis of their relationship. When Jumman went for Hajj, he left his house in the care of Algu. And whenever Algu went away, he left his house in the care of Jumman. Neither did they eat with each other, nor did they follow the same religion. They only had similar perspectives. And this is the secret of their friendship. Their friendship took root when they were children, and Jumman's venerable father, Jumrati, used to teach them. Algu had served his teacher diligently, had scrubbed dishes and washed cups. He had never allowed his hakka to go cold, since each time he set the chillum, he would be away from his books for half an hour. Hakka, hubble bubble, Indian device for smoking tobacco, which allows the smoke to pass through water. Algu's father was an old-fashioned schoolman. He had great faith and service to the teacher. He used to say that education came from the blessings of the teacher, not from books. One only needed the benevolence of the teacher. So in case Algu does not benefit from the grace or company of his teacher Jumrati Sheikh, he would console himself by holding that he had left no stone unturned in the quest for education for his son. But if the boy was destined to have no education, how would he have acquired it? But Jumrati Sheikh himself did not favor the idea of grace. He had more faith in his thick stick, and it is by the grace of that stick that Juman was worshipped in the nearby villages. Even the clerk of the court could not correct a sale deed or a letter of apothecation formulated by him. From the postman and constable of the area to the peon at the local revenue office, everybody desired his grace. So while Algu was respected for his wealth, Juman Sheikh had won respect because of his priceless knowledge in the matters of law. Juman Sheikh had an old Kala. She owned some property but had no close relatives on the husband's side. Juman had made her transfer the property in his name by making grand promises to her. So long as the gift deed had not been registered, old Kala was well taken care of. She was showered with the best foods. However, whilst the registry was executed, the preferential treatment meted out to Kala stopped. Juman's wife, Kariman, began to serve her sharp taunts with plain food. Juman Sheikh was also cold with her. Poor Kala was reduced to suffering taunts almost daily. How long is the old woman going to live? Seems she has brought us by giving us those niggardly feels. She can't eat her food unless there is ghee in the dal. We could have bought a whole village with the amount of money we have thrown into her tummy. For some time, old Kala bore the sharp words. When she couldn't take that anymore, she complained to Juman. Juman did not deem it fit to interfere in this matter of home management. Some more days passed. At last, one day Kala said to Juman, "Son, I cannot live with you. Just give me money. I will cook for myself." Juman retorted rudely, "Does money grow on trees?" Kala humbly asked, "Am I not going to need something to eat?" In a serious tone, Juman replied, "No one thought you would live so long." Kala was agitated and warned him she would take him to the panchayat. Juman laughed like the hunter who sees the deer walk towards the snare. "Certainly, call the panchayat by all means." Juman was sure who would win in the panchayat. Who in nearby villages could dare to stand against him? Who could confront him? Angels won't be coming to the panchayat. After this, bending over her stick, old Kala went from village to village. She was tired. Each step was agony. But now, things had come to a head. They needed to be finalized. It must have been a rare upright man to whom the old woman did not recount her sorry tale. Some just heard her unwillingly, while others cursed the times for this injustice. You never know when you might die, but your greed is unending. What more do you want? Eat your food and think of God. What do you have to do with farming now? Some good people found in all this a good opportunity to have fun. A bent back, a toothless mouth, hair like skeins of jute, all material enough for laughter. Few men listened to her problem seriously and consoled her. After roaming all over, the poor Kala came to Algu Chaudhary. She threw her stick down and after a pause said, "Son, you also come to the panchayat I have called. Look at the people who are mocking at this old woman. Algu, why have me there? There will be men from several villages. Khala, I counted my story to all and sundry. It's up to them whether they will come or not. Algu emphasized, even if I come, I will not open my mouth in the panchayat. Khala, why son? Algu, Juman is my old friend. I cannot spoil my friendship with him. Khala, so just because of the fear of spoiling your relations with Juman, you will not speak for what is right? Will you compromise on your iman? While it hibernates, our sense of righteousness knows not if all is robbed, but it wakes up when challenged. Then none can win over it. Algu was unable to answer, but Khala's words echoed in his heart. Because of the fear of spoiling your relations, you will not support truth. So what do you think, children? Will these words have an impact in his mind and heart? Let's listen to the story further and let's move further. In the evening, the panchayat assembled under the tree. Sheikh Juman had a carpet spread. He had also provided cardamoms, tobacco, hookah, etc. for the gathering. He was sitting at some distance from Algu. He welcomed entrants to the panchayat with subdued salam. When the sun set and the chirping assembly of birds settled in the trees, the panchayat below began its proceedings. Every inch of the carpet was occupied, but most of the people were mere spectators. Only those of the invited gentlemen who had a score to settle with Juman had come. In one corner, a fire was going on. The Nai was busy readying chillums. It was difficult to determine what produced more smoke, the chillums or the burning of dung cakes. Children ran amok. Some swore at each other. Some cried. There was complete chaos, considering the assemblage to be a feast. Gangs of dogs gathered in anticipation. After the punch settled, old Khala addressed them. Punch, 3 years ago, I had transferred all my property to my nephew Juman. You all know him well. Juman committed to provide for my basic needs of food and clothing all my life. I have somehow passed year after year with him in suffering. Now I cannot bear this anymore. I get neither food nor clothes. I am a helpless widow. I cannot go to the court. Apart from you, who will I share my troubles with? I will follow whatever you decide. If you find me at fault, punish me. If you find Juman wrong, then make him understand that he should not incur a curse from a suffering soul. I will humbly accept the order of the Panchs. Ramdhan Mishra, many of whose debtors Juman had helped settle in his village, said, "Who do you wish to choose as Panch Juman? Settle that right now. You will have to accept their verdict." Juman saw that the Panchs were mostly people who had unresolved issues with him. Juman said, "The Panch's decision is God's decision. Khala may name whosoever she wishes to be her Panch. I have no objection." Khala shouted, "Why don't you name the Panchs?" Juman angrily retorted, "Don't make me open my mouth. Things are in your favor. Name the person you want to be your Panch." Khala sensed the accusation. "Be scared of God, son. A Panch is no one's friend or enemy." What a thing to say. If none else, at least You trust Algu Chaudhary? Here, I nominate him as Sarpanch. Sarpanch is the chief panch. Their vote generally decided a case. Jumman Sheikh was delighted, but hiding his emotions, he said, "All right, so Algu it is. To me, it makes no difference." Algu didn't wish to be involved in this matter. He tried to wriggle out of it. He said, "Khala, you know that I have a strong friendship with Jumman." In a serious tone, Khala responded, "Son, one cannot compromise on his iman for friendship. God resides in the panch's heart. God speaks through him." Algu Chaudhary became the sarpanch. Ramdhan Mishra and other opponents of Jumman cursed old Khala in their hearts. Algu Chaudhary began, "Sheikh Jumman, we are old friends. You have helped me whenever the need arose, and I too have been serving you within my capacity. But right now, you and old Khala are equal in my eyes. Whatever you want to submit to the panch, please do." Jumman was confident that now he would win the case, and Algu was only pretending. He spoke nonchalantly. 3 years ago, Khala transferred her property in my name. I committed to provide her with clothing and food all her life. God is my witness. I have caused Khala no trouble to date. I consider her as my mother. To serve her is my duty, but women have squabbles among them. What can I do? Khala also demands a monthly allowance. The panchs are aware of what the property amounts to. It does not give much profit, so I cannot give her a monthly allowance. Also, at the time of transfer of property, there was no mention of a monthly allowance. Otherwise, I would have never got myself involved in this ruckus. This is all I have to say. Now it's up to the panch. Whatever they deem fit. Algu Chaudhary had to frequently deal with the court. He was aware of legal points and issues. He began to question Jumman. Every question was a blow to Juman's heart. Ramdhan was pleased with his questions. Jumman was in shock over the change in Algu. He was thinking, what has come over him? Just now he had been talking to me in a different way. Now he is completely transformed and has turned against me. What is he trying to avenge? Will our long friendship not help me? Jumman Sheikh was lost in thought when Algu announced the decision. Well, what could that decision be? Let's listen. Jumman Sheikh, the panchs have considered this matter. They find it justified that Khala Jaan should be given a monthly allowance. We are of the opinion that her property yields profit enough to pay her a monthly allowance. This is a decision. If Jumman does not agree to pay her expenses, the transfer of property should be considered cancelled. Jumman was shocked when a friend behaves like an enemy and stabs one in the back. What else can it be called if not a trick of time? The one man whom he trusted had cheated him when he needed him the most. So let's see further. Such occasions reveal the true colors of friends. This is friendship in the dark age of moral decline. If people were not cheats, why would calamities have befallen the country? Diseases like the plague and cholera are punishment for wrong deeds. But Ramdhan Mishra and other panchs were heartily praising Algu's decision. They said, "Now this is a real panchayat, all clean and clear. Friendship has its own importance, but fulfilling an obligation is paramount. It is only because of such honest people that the world is stable. Otherwise, it would have sunk to the lowest depths." Well, I also agree with this point. This decision hit hard at Jumman and Algu's friendship. They were no longer seen speaking with each other. Their old friendship could not bear the heat of one truth. Now, the two just observed civilities. They welcomed each other more elaborately. They met as a sword meets the shield. His friend's cunning galled Jumman day and night. Each waking moment, he sought an opportunity to take revenge. Well, let's see what is the twist in the story now. Good deeds take a long time to reach fruition. Bad deeds don't. Jumman soon got his opportunity for revenge. Last year, Algu Chaudhary had bought a good team of oxen. These oxen from the western parts were handsome animals with long horns. For months, people came to see them. 1 month after the panchayat, one of those oxen died. Jumman confided to his friends, "This is the punishment for cheating." "Humans may be patient, but God sees everything." Algu suspected that Jumman might have been behind the poisoning of the ox. Algu's wife also blamed Jumman. She said, "This is certainly Jumman's doing." One day, Algu's and Jumman's wives had a sharp exchange of words over this. Both women taunted each other. Jumman somehow restored peace. He scolded his wife and managed to take her away from the battlefield. Algu, on the other hand, used his unfailingly logical stick to talk sense to his wife. "A single ox is no use to anyone." Algu searched for a compatible ox everywhere but could not find one. Finally, he decided to sell it. Samchu Sahu had a bullock cart which he used to transport clarified butter and jaggery from the village to the local market and oil and salt from the market to sell in the village. He was enamored of Algu's ox. Sahu had planned on making the ox do 3 trips in one day. Currently, his ox had trouble making 1 trip in a day. He tested Algu's ox thoroughly and bought it. He promised to pay the agreed price after a month. Algu needed to get rid of the ox. He did not worry about the loss. Samju Sahu drove the ox hard. He began to make 3 to 4 trips in one day. He did not feed the ox well. At the market, he would give it some dry grass. Before the poor beast could rest, he was hitched to the cart again. At Algu's house, it had had an easy life. When it was hitched to a light cart once in a blue moon, it pranced and ran for miles. There the ox used to be fed clean water, split pigeon pea, oil cake mixed with hay, and sometimes ghee as well. In the evening, he was brushed by a man. After that pleasant life, the ox was forced to work hard all the time. Within a month, he began to be tired. The slight of the yoke made his blood run cold. Every step was agony. His bones showed, but he was spirited and could not bear being hit. One day, on the 4th trip, Sahu loaded him with twice the usual load. The tired animal could hardly walk, but Sahu lashed at him. The ox made one last effort. It ran some distance and then tried to rest, but Sahu was in a rush, so he cruelly lashed at him again. The ox tried again, but his strength gave up. He fell, never got up again. Sahu beat him, pulled him by the leg, pushed his stick through its nostrils. But do the dead ever arise? Finally, suspecting something amiss, Sahu checked the ox carefully. Then he thought about taking the cart home. He shouted and yelled for help a lot, but by dusk, the village roads were empty. There was no village nearby. Angrily, he started cursing the dead ox. "If you had to die, then why didn't you die at home? Why in the middle of the road?" Now, who was going to pull the cart? Sahu was very angry. He had sold several bags of jaggery and barrels of ghee, and so had around 200 to 250 rupees with him. Also, the cart held bags of salt, so he could not have left it. The poor man lay down on the cart and decided to keep watch all night. He smoked the chillum, sang, and then smoked his hookah. He thought he had been awake. When he woke up at dawn and checked, the pouch of money was missing. He nervously glanced around only to find that several cans of oil had vanished as well. He beat his forehead. He writhed in the dust, crying and howling. He reached home in the morning. His wife wept when she heard this bad news. Then she cursed Algu Chaudhary for giving them an inauspicious ox, because of whom they had lost their life's earnings. A few months after this incident, when Algu Chaudhary asked for payment, Sahu and his wife turned upon him, shouting and blaming that he gave them a dead ox, that they suffered a huge loss, and he had the gall to ask for payment for that ox. They cursed Algu and told him to take their ox for 2 months. They had nothing to give him. Algu also had a number of enemies who would gather to justify Sahu whenever he squabbled with him. But 150 rupees is not an easy sum to lose. The squabbles continued. Once Algu lost his temper and Sahu went into his house to get his stick. At this point, Sahu's wife took command of the field. Slowly, the argument turned to fracas. Sahu's wife went into her house and shut the door. On hearing the noise, some well-meaning people gathered and counseled both parties to call a panchayat to settle the issue once for all. Preparations for the panchayat began in earnest. Both parties formed their own groups. On the third day, a panchayat was conducted under the very same tree. This time too, it was taking place in the evening. The crows were holding their own panchayat in the fields. The parrots sat in council in the tree. As the panchayat assembled, Ramdhan Mishra said, "What are we waiting for? Let's select the panch. Chaudhary, who do you want to be your panch?" He said softly, "Let Sahu do the selecting." Sahu roared, "I choose Juman Sheikh." Algu's heart beat fast, as if someone had slapped him hard. Ramdhan asked, "Chaudhary, do you have any objection?" Chaudhary sounded disheartened. "No, what objection would I have?" A sense of responsibility often improves our narrow ideas. When we flounder, it becomes a reliable guide. Sitting in their peaceful cottage, an editor uses their powerful pen to launch arrogant, free attacks on the cabinets. But there comes a time when they themselves become a part of the cabinet. Their writing then turns thoughtful and just. This happens because of their sense of responsibility. A man is so haughty in his youth. How his parents worry for him? They think of him as a blot on the fair name of their family. But with the coming of the responsibility for a family, the same crazy, bumptious youth becomes calm and patient. This results from a sense of responsibility. As he occupied the high seat of Sarpanch, the sense of responsibility emerged in Juman Sheikh's mind. He thought, "I am occupying the highest seat of justice and trust. What I speak will be equivalent to God's will, and God's will must not be mixed with the impurities of my mind. I must not budge from the path of truth." The Panch questioned both sides. For a long time, both sides went on justifying their actions. All agreed that Sahu must pay for the ox. Two of the Panchs wished to extend Sahu a concession because he had suffered losses due to the death of the ox, while two others felt that Sahu should be punished. The punishment would act as a deterrent against abusing animals. In the end, Jumman announced his decision. Algu Chaudhary and Samju Sahu, we have considered the matter in detail. It is only right that Samju pay the cost of the ox. At the time he took delivery of the ox, it had been healthy. Had the cost been paid at that time, Samju Sahu would not have gone back on his word about paying it. The ox died because it was overworked, overused, and was not fed properly. Ramdhan Mishra suggested that Sahu had killed the ox intentionally and so he should be fined. Jumman refused to consider the point. Someone said Sahu should be given some concession, but Jumman said they were leaving the issue for Algu Chaudhary to consider. Algu Chaudhary hailed the verdict with enthusiasm. Panch Parmeshwar ki jai. The crowd echoed the sentiment, Panch Parmeshwar ki jai. Panch Parmeshwar ki jai means hail the Panch, the representative of God. Everyone praised Juman's decision. They said this was real justice. Coming up with such a decision was not the act of a mere human. In the mind of the Panch resided Parmeshwar. It was his divine justice. Then Jumman came to Algu and embraced him. Ever since you had delivered that verdict for me, I had become your sworn enemy. Today I realize that the one who sits as a Panch is no one's friend or enemy. He only sees justice. Now I have realized that God speaks through the Panch. Algu wept. The salt water cleansed their hearts. The wilted wine of friendship thrived again. And there they were, hugging and cuddling each other. And that is the end of the story. Thank you so much.